We all have that thing in our house, or we have that thing in our life that is like a prized possession, something that we hold near and dear to our heart. Something that you get excited to maybe show people when they come around, and it's worth a lot to you, maybe a lot of value, or it's a family heirloom that was passed down, that was given to you, and you're happy that you got it, and you uphold it, and you want the world, or you put it on display. It's a prized possession for you. Well, in James 1:18, it says, he chose to give birth to us by giving us his true word, and that out of all creation, we became his prized possession. That's James 1:18 of the New Living Translation. And in the Greek translation, it says, right in that prized possession area, that we are the first fruits of all creation, or all creatures. I'm here to tell you today that you are God's prized possession, that he holds you near and dear to his heart, that he upholds you and wants you to be able to show like a light for the world to be able to see. That because of Jesus, his true word, because God sent his son Jesus on the cross, and Jesus is the word. So he sent the true word so that we could become God's prized possession above all creation. So today, I want you to understand who you are in Christ. I want you to understand that your identity is the prized possession, that God holds you near and dear to his heart, that he wants to put you on display for the world to see, so that people cannot see your glory, but see his glory shining through you, his light coming from you. Because above all creation, he holds you near and dear to his heart, that you are the first fruits of all creatures. So today, no matter what has been going on in your life, no matter what you have gone through, no matter what the mistakes that you have made, no matter all the things that you may have done, even there's so many people that I hear and they tell me, I don't feel good enough to do what it is that God's called me to do. I've made too many mistakes to do what he's called me to do. I've sinned too much. Let me tell you, he sent his true word. His word was Jesus to wash all of your past, present, and future sins away. So no one is perfect. No one is perfect. But one thing I can tell you, that you are, that even though the mistakes that you made, you are still loved by God. Even though the things that you may not feel good enough, he still thinks you're great. Even though you may look at yourself and not feel like everything is all together, he is looking at you like, baby girl or son, I got you. Because all things work together for the good of those who love. Walk right with me, who stay on track with me, because you need God. You need him. You need him to guide you. You need him to help you. And you know what? He wants to help you because you're his prized possession. He wants to show you. He wants to put you on display. He wants your destiny to be fulfilled. He wants your purpose to be carried out. He wants what it is that he's called for you to manifest in your life. So understand your identity in Christ today, and know that because of his son Jesus, the true word of God, you are his prized possession. You are what he looks and says, look at her, look at him. I'm so excited about what they're doing. I don't care the mistakes that they've made. I don't care about the things that they've done. I'm excited because they're walking upright. They're doing what's right. They're trying their best. They're doing all they can. I'm gonna help them be the best that they can be because they're my prized possession. I hold them near and dear to my heart. So don't allow the world to diminish your light or diminish your purpose by believing what the world may say about you or believing that your sins can overtake you, because your sins have been washed by Christ. Which is why if you go further from James 1:18, it tells you that you must walk in obedience. You must continue to walk upright. You must do what's right. Don't try to be like the world, but be like Christ. Walk in your light and don't allow any of the things that's gone on in your life to diminish your light. But you walk in your purpose and you understand that you are prized possession of God. And he loves you and he cares for you and he wants what's best for you, because he sent his son, his word, to be able to make you his prized possession, that he can hold up for the world to see, no matter what you've done, no matter the mistakes you've made, and no matter the choices you've made, he still wants to show you off as his prized possession. So I ask you today to walk in your purpose and understand that you are valuable, I hope you were blessed by this message. I decree and declare abundance and favor over your life, and I will see you next week.